Welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Yeah, today it's a wonderful weather. The sun is not shining right at the moment, but as you saw in my earlier footage, it has been a wonderful day here. I'm out in Hammer Hills. It's long time since I've been out here, so I thought it was a good idea. And I got me some new stuff I would like to show you and talk a little bit about. First of all, this one you can see in this picture is a thing you can use when you are steaming vegetables in your pot. And I've seen others use it for the purpose I'm doing it. It's actually so that the fire won't go down in the ground and start a fire deep in the ground. When you light a fire like I do, I don't have my bushbox essential with me today, then there's a risk that the fire will spread under. So this will prevent that and keep it a little bit more safe. And I think that's very important to have safety about when you're making your fire. So I could recommend you to buy one of these. It's awesome, it's compact, it doesn't take much room in my little bag there. So in the future I'm going to use that when I'm making fire like this, like a little bonfire. Yeah. Even I can do it like this. It's not stable. No. It's not stable enough for that. I have to figure out a system that I can use when I'm doing this. Of course, if I had my gloves with me, that would probably help a little bit. Yeah. And now the smoke is coming my way. The wind is changing all the time. So yeah, and this little pot is called a cauldron, I think, or cauldron. It's hand forged, and you can see it's really old school. It's something they could have used in the Viking Age. And this one I carved, a pot hanger. I think it's very cool. A little seahorse or something like that. And it shoots it very well. And this system I made here, so I can hang it up and down, lower down and higher up if I want to do that. But this one, I'm particularly very fond of. I think it's cool, and I'm going to use this every time I'm out here with my backpack frame, my Viking series. I'll use this for making coffee and of course also preparing food in this. Yeah, and a couple of months ago I was contacted by this author, by this guy, William V. Forty, MD. He's a doctor, and he wrote this book, you can see, the Preppers Medical Handbook. And I read a little bit in it. It's very, how many pages? Almost 300 pages, so it's a large book. It covers most of the
things you can imagine if you're going to be a prepper or survivalist. This stands here, he writes, learn how to prepare for medical emergencies on off the grid, managing bone, joint, soft tissues and other trauma, managing under circumstances, I don't know what that means, pain and fever, dental emergencies, bioterrorism, environmental emergencies, radiation exposure and poisoning. So in this book he covers a lot of issues about if you are out in the woods or in the nature and you are only yourself or perhaps a couple of persons with you. There's not a lot of pictures in here. There's some diagrams and other stuff you can read. And, well, I'll just read up here. How to prepare for medical care on the grid. Assessment and stabilization. Body systems, symptoms and management, radiation, dental care, tissue care and trauma management, orthopedic bone and joint pain and injuries, bite and stings, so snake bites and stings from bees and so on, bioterrorism and infection disease, environmental injuries, the off-grid medical kit, and you can see there's a lot of items that he's writing about in this book, and if you are English, and I think it's easy for you to read this. For me, it's a little bit problem because I'm not English from birth. I'm Danish, so some of the terms in here I just not quite understand. But most of it is very easy to understand what he's writing. So I can definitely recommend you to go in and buy this. I think if I can put a link where you can buy it. It's a very comprehensive handbook if you're a prepper, a survivalist or just practicing bushcrafts. So I'll see if I can put a link below in my video description, and you can go in and read more about this book from William. Thank you, William, for sending me this. I appreciate that very much. And in the future, I'll take this with me when I'm out on longer hikes, so I can be a little bit wiser regarding the issues, the subjects you are writing about in this book. And just shortly about the food I ate here. You can see this this is meatballs. It's called in Swedish, we call it frikadella. And it's very tasty. It's pork meat. And you just fry them on the pan. And I put some beetroots on in my sandwich. It was very delicious.